Hi, everybody. I'm very honored to talk here today. My name is Ken, CEO of Soracom. I left Amazon Web Services 3 years ago and create Soracom. So quick question. Anybody knows Amazon Web Services? Raise your hand. Oh, everybody knows AWS. How about Soracom? Anybody knows Soracom? Everybody knows Soracom. Great. Right? So actually, Soracom provide platform for connectivity to IoT. We have more than 9,000 customers, and we have been raising money about $37 million so far. And we are expanding our business globally. So Forbes, Forbes recognized me as number two entrepreneur in Japan in 2017. Personally, I enjoyed my triathlon race, and I have 3 kids. So I spend my effort to my company in weekday, but I spend all of my weekend to playing with kids. So today I want to talk about entrepreneurship in Japan, how I came to start Soracom, and also what the 3 year journey looks like. So let me talk about my career background first. I worked on master degree at Tokyo University and joined IBM Research and work on wearable computing project called Watchpad. This is cutting edge research prototyping, Linux-based accelerometer and fingerprint sensor. This is in 2000. But this project was a little bit too ahead of its time. So one day, my boss assembled us to let us know this project was canceled. So in retrospective, IBM management team decided to sell personal computing division to Lenovo. So the project was funded by ThinkPad team, personal computing division. So naturally, this project need to end. This incident made me more interested in business side. If you want to bring your product into market, you need to know not engineering, but also sales and marketing. So I moved to IBM sales department. I worked very hard for 3 years. And then I got the IBM scholarship and went to Carnegie Mellon to work on MBA. Coincidentally, at the same time, Amazon started AWS business in the US. So when I first tried Amazon Web Service, I was very surprised. Just press button, you can make server. Before AWS, if we want to make server, you need to do a lot of things. Buy physical server, you know, wire a lot of cable, install OS, you know, supply power, everything, right? Heavy lifting work. But it was shocked for me to make and operate server so easily. So I felt in the moment the world would change. But I'm company sponsored student from IBM Japan, so I need to go back to IBM. 2 years later, there was a single phone call. I took that phone call from headhunter. He told me, Amazon is going to start AWS business in Japan. Why don't you start this business? Oh my god, I want to do this, right? So I you know, wanted to do this, but there was one problem. My contract with IBM specified, if I leave within 5 years after MBA graduation, I need to pay back MBA tuition. I have 3 kids. But you know, I paid back all of tuition. That amount was $100,000. But I joined AWS as a technical evangelist. So I think when you think about entrepreneurship, this is very important. I'm not typical entrepreneur profile. Start company, be CEO, and you know, see my name in press. That was not my ambition. My motivation was bring new things coming from the future. So I joined AWS as a technical evangelist. And I really like the, you know, the kind of like a business of AWS doing, because this gave a significant impact startup community. Before AWS, even if developer wanted to make a new services, they need to buy physical server. It's very expensive, right? After AWS, they just need to make server and then start building application. Small start. It's a small start, right? So naturally, there are many startups emerging from, especially from United States. You can name it, Airbnb, Instagram, Dropbox. All of the startups started using AWS. So I wanted to do that in Japan. I wanted to developers, innovators, to make new application and go global using AWS. So that was my motivation. And that motivation drove me to deliver a lot of presentations in conference all over the Japan. So I delivered more than 160 presentations in Japan in 2011. So in the result, AWS has been spreading very successfully in Japan. So many, many enterprises and startups use AWS. So I guess the business of AWS Japan is more than $1 billion right now. So I think that was great for me because I'm one of the initiator of AWS Japan business. But if you look at the technology startups who use AWS and then make and change the world and go global, unfortunately, not many, right? This is not my fault because there are several reasons. If you look at the startup ecosystem, less mature startup ecosystem in Japan. If you look at the invest money from VC, US has 50 times bigger than Japan. And also, Japan is the third largest single country. So most of the startup CEO, they are kind of satisfied not going with global. So it's not my fault though, but I felt like I felt really bad as an AWS evangelist. And 2014, I had a business trip to Seattle, and I had a beer with my friend, Kenta Yasukawa. He's a current CTO of Soracom. And we had a big conversation. We believe we can make any type of application, any mission-critical application on top of AWS Cloud. That we believe. But most of people don't think that. Most of people, they cannot make mission-critical system on top of AWS Cloud because due to the security issues and also availability issue. So there was a big gap between what we believe and what they believe. So after the beer session, I went back to hotel. I tried to sleep, but I was not sleeping in Seattle in jet lag. So I had a, I did a little exercise. I wrote fictional press release. In that press release, the company made telecom core network on top of AWS. Entire telecom core system as software on the cloud and provide very flexible, secure mobile communication to the customer. Next morning, I woke up, I read the press release, and I felt like this is not fiction. This can be possible, right? So this was actually a real press release I wrote. Sorry, this is in Japanese. So I quit AWS, and I have a co-founder already, Kenta, and nothing more. But I started talking this story to the best engineer I've ever worked with. So I made a small team of 10 and work on this project in the stealth mode. And also I started talking about this story to the investors. And successfully, we funded about $7 million in 2015 spring. Then we published our platform, Soracom. So this is the initiating member. So let me talk about overview of Soracom. In the IoT concept, numerous things are connected to internet. And a lot of big data analyzed in the cloud. And control back devices and things, right? Very cool, exciting. But when it comes to implementing IoT application, you need to do a lot of things. Especially when I worked in the AWS, many customers are struggling with data communication part. How they can send data from real object to the cloud. So Wi-Fi is okay, but a security issue, right? So we developed Soracom, which is the secure, flexible, wireless communication to the cloud. So we will provide a SIM card, and you can buy this SIM card from Amazon or our website from one SIM card. So you can start, you know, very quickly. And also, you can control all over the connectivities from a website or API. You can start, stop connectivity, or check the logs, or you know, you can change the speed of the wireless communication. Now, we have more than 9,000 of customers from enterprise. This is a part of the public customer references, and many startups across the industry. So let me introduce some of the interesting use cases. Tokachi Bus, which is the local bus company, they put Soracom into all of buses. And then they send location data, GPS data, to the cloud. And they provide a smartphone application, and customer can find the best route, which bus they should take, right? And sometimes bus tend to delay when it snows, so they can get those notifications. So this is very convenient, right? So we provide low-cost connectivity, so they can run this system about $3 per month for one bus. Another example is Wheel. They are a very cool startup company, provide personal mobility. So this new model integrates Soracom as a connectivity. So when their customer have any problem, their support center can do maintenance from a remotely, so they can identify what is the issue, like, you know, battery power, you know, is dying, or you know, any device setting are not correct, and so on. Another example is Daido Drinko, which is one of the largest beverage company in Japan. So they put Soracom for more than 50,000 vending machine. So they can get all of the data of sales data, inventory data of the, you know, vending machines. So you can get the idea, right? So we provide flexible wireless communication, and customer can use that and then make innovative IoT application. So you might wonder how we provide this kind of system as a startup, right? So if you want to provide SIM card, you need to become a telecom operator. NTT Docomo, SoftBank, AT&T, T-Mobile, Orange, they need to do a lot of investment to the physical infrastructure. They need to build a lot of cell towers, huge data center. They need to buy telecom equipment, very expensive, few million dollars per one equipment. We take different approach. We don't own any physical infrastructure. We contract with those telecom operator, and then we got the bulk access to cell tower. Then having a physical network line to AWS cloud, and we built software telecom core network system on top of AWS. So we are very unique virtual telecom core network operator focusing on IoT connectivity, providing open, fair, flexible wireless connectivity. The interesting part of this business model, so our core asset is only software. So we can bring this to the global. So we can bring this to the AWS data center in any country. So we started expanding our system to the global. And now we, in 2016, we raised about $30 million for the global expansion. And we announced global version of SIM card. You just need to insert this SIM card. You will get connectivity in more than 100 countries. And we have an office in Seattle, San Francisco, Singapore, you know, Paris, and Denmark. So now our team is turning into global team, which is I dreamed before. Last August, KDDI acquired Soracom. So this was a big announcement. This news got a lot of attention because tech startup M&A was very rare in Japan. And also the amount of money was huge. After this announcement, my friend and, you know, the customer told me, "Ken, congratulations on exit. Congratulations on exit." My answer was this: exit? No, 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 this is not exit. This is entrance. So I wrote a blog. So because my passion was make global platform. And then this was a significant milestone. We can get the entrance to the access to KDDI's physical infrastructure and a lot of resources. So now we are the ready for going global. I want to end this presentation showing one video, which is our customer's video.
We can brighten every day with the things we can say. Just be happy.
ひーばあちゃんお元気ですか？僕はサッカー、小学校でサッカーをしてこんなに黒くなりました。
この間ものすごくおしゃべりした。
ひーばあちゃん大好き。夏休みに遊びに行くよ。
はいはい。
3年保育。
写真を見ると違う
でしょうか。違う。全然。おばあちゃんも楽しんでますよ。
So this customer, our customer, Mago Channel, they use Soracom in the small set-top box. So grandma can see photos and videos on the TV. Actually, that grandma is 101 years old, and the real grandma of my wife. So the kids are appearing, my kids are appearing on the video. So the grandma is the oldest age customer of these services. So CEO Kajiwara-san wanted to make an advertisement video. So this customer, this service is one of my favorite services because they use Soracom. This is joking. Because they are making very innovative services. And we empower them to do that. So I hope many, many developers here, engineers, businessmen, try to make new IoT innovative services, change the world, go global, and we empower you to do that. So this is 3 years of my story. I didn't come out become an entrepreneur. I was enjoying research life in IBM with a big team, with a lot of resources. But because I follow my passion in technology, I got a strong vision for the future looks like. So for you, I think you should know there is one thing that only you can bring into the world. Once you find it, everything else will become possible. Thank you for your attention.